How to create an email sequence and automation in GrooveMail. What's up guys, Amy here. So in the first video of the GrooveMail tutorial series, I show you how to set up sender identities, create an email list, create tags, opt-in forms, and embed it in Groove Pages. If you haven't seen that video, I suggest you watch that video first before watching this video, and I'll leave the link below. In this video, we're going to continue with the same example, add a welcome email sequence, and create an automation. All right, you ready? Let's go. All right, guys. First, we're going to log into GrooveFunnels and click on the GrooveMail app. And guys, if you're new to GrooveMail, you can support the channel by creating your free GrooveMail account and get up to 500 email contacts for free at amybo.com/freelander and receive extra training bonuses from me as well. The first step is creating a sequence, and you do that by going to campaigns and clicking on sequence. Let's close out of this. I've got a test sequence up already, but we're gonna go through the whole process again by clicking on new sequence and giving it a name. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to set up a 6-part welcome email series. So let's call this free meal plan welcome series. Under description, we'll call this 6-part welcome email series and then click on create. And once you click on create sequence, it will transition to this email sequence builder. We're going to go under actions and drag in this send email element and pop it into the canvas. Over on your right, your configuration tab will pop open. So let's go through it. Under the name of the email, since this is the first email in the sequence, let's call this Welcome Series Email 1. Under Gateway, you will select GrooveMail Server. Under Sender, you will select your name as a sender or whichever sender name that you've set up previously. So I'm going to click on this. And guys, if you don't have any sender options here, then please watch my first GrooveMail tutorial where I show you how to set up sender details. Under Content, this will be the subject headline of your email. I'm going to call it Welcome to Gym Gains. Under Preview, this will be a sentence snippet that users will see before they open up their email. We'll add Welcome to Gym Gains, you're at the right place. Under Message, this is where you'll add in your email copy. So to personalize your email, you will type in Hey, scroll down a bit and click on First Name, and then type in comma to the next line. And I'll paste in some email copy I prepared earlier. So even though I'm showing you how to set up an email sequence, I'm going to provide some tips on what to write in your welcome email series. Now, the email that gets the highest open rate is usually your first email, i.e. the welcome to my list email, which is email 1. This is where you deliver your lead magnet or what you promise people in exchange for their contact details. You get people to actually use your lead magnet or the product. You give them helpful information. You might want to tell your backstory or your brand story and tell people what to expect in the next email series and ask people to take an action like reply to this email or check out this particular page. Now, just a slight interruption, guys. It does take a lot of time to plan and make these tutorials for you. And I would so appreciate it if you can click on that like button while you're watching this video right now. And if you could please leave a comment as the YouTube algorithm kicks in, and this video will reach even more people and help them out as well. Thanks a lot. Back to the tutorial now. Now, a lot of people think that they can't sell in a welcome series or an onboarding email series. I would totally disagree with this. The format of it is usually send a couple of nurture emails, then introduce people to who you are and what you do, share one or two personal stories that are engaging, that are emotional, then you can ask people to buy whatever it is you want them to buy. All right, so that's basically the layout of what to write in your first welcome email. You would scroll down here under send status, click on that and click active, then click done. Now, with a welcome or email autoresponder series, you may decide to have 6 emails sent one day apart. So let's head over here under timing, drag in a time delay and pop it here. Let's configure the delay and click on wait, a number of days and hours. Type in 1 for one day or even 12 hours apart, depending on your email sequence before the next email is sent. Under date and time, I'm just going to leave as is and allow GrooveMail to send it on any time of the day. Scroll down and send status is on active. We're going to click on done. Let's head back over here and then drag in the second email that we're going to send out. So continuing the welcome email series, over on the right here, we'll call this welcome series email 2. The gateway and sender name is already preset for us. So we'll move down to content. And under subject headline for email 2, you can introduce what problem you could solve for the prospect. For the preview snippet, I'm just going to add, what if you could solve XYZ problem? And we'll scroll up to the message. Let's type, hey, again, personalize it. So hopefully you would have your email copy prepared. But if you don't know what to write in the second email, here are some guidelines. Now, your prospect has problems. The thing you sell solves this problem. But no one will buy your thing if they don't believe you can solve their problem in the first place. The second email shows that there is a solution to their problem. So if you think of the buyer's journey, they go from I'm aware I have a problem to solution aware. Which means in the email copy, you can tell a story of a client who has a problem, what they need to do to solve that problem, and what they think they need to do but actually don't in order to solve that problem. So once you answer those questions in your email by tearing down the thing they think they need and fill in the thing they actually need, that can form the basis of the second email. Once you've done so, go to send status, click on active, and then press done. Now, in order to build out this sequence, I'm going to hold on the canvas, pull this up so I can see a bit more, and then release. Let's head over here and add another time delay by dragging it in. We're going to leave it at wait a number of days, one day, allow it to send at any time of the day, and click on done. We'll drag in another email under actions and pop it here. We'll name this email welcome series email 3. Scroll down a bit under subject. I'll call this It's Not Your Fault. Add the same for the preview. And for email 3, a type of email content you could send is It's Not Your Fault. So you can do this by introducing a personal story about a problem. For example, eating healthy was not always an option growing up for you. Then you mention why it's not their fault. And I could say my parents worked a lot and I found myself eating whatever was available, instant noodles or microwave meals. It took me years of learning nutrition, eating the foods that were nutritionally dense to fill my body. Basically, the core message of the third email in the welcome series is this can be hard, no one teaches you it, it's not your fault, and here's how you can solve XY problem. Then you scroll down and then click on done. I'll pull this up again, and now we're going to add another timer delay by dragging this in. We'll also set it to one day and then click done. Head back over here and then drag in the fourth email. We'll name this Welcome Series Email 4. Now for the subject headline, I'll scroll this up a bit. You can talk about 5 benefits. For preview, I can write, here's 5 benefits to your problem. In this email, you're going to address how your offer can change someone's life. So you need to convince the reader that you can help them. You future pace your reader by telling them the benefits at 4 stages. So right after buying your product, a month after buying your product, a few months or a year after buying the product, and the rest of your life. So you want to lay out the benefits in the above order and use phrases like think about, what if, imagine, essentially future pacing the possible benefits your prospect could achieve by buying your product. And in terms of these, you can outline it as a story of one of your successful clients and what happened to them right after they bought the product or a month after they bought the product and so forth. So once you've completed this particular email, just go down here and then press done. Let's head over here and drag in another timer delay and pop it there. Now for the fifth email, I might set this to 12 hours instead of 1 day and click here, then click on done. Hold this and scroll it up, and then we'll head to actions, drag in the fifth email. We'll call this welcome series email 5. For the subject headline, you want to create some urgency, so it's your time to sell. And for the preview, I might type in, you need to read this email. Under message, what I'm going to cover here is what you should write in email 5 and 6 of your welcome email series. So I'll paste in some notes here. And essentially, email 5 and 6 is where you make the sales, right? If you've ever run an email funnel for a product launch, you would know that most of the sales come at the end. Sure, some people will buy in the beginning of the email series. However, email 5 and 6 is your last chance to make the sales. So email 5 and 6 are usually sent on the same day to ramp up urgency. Now for email 5, this is where you have urgency, but you include features and benefits. Countdown timers work really well in email 5, and you can paint a sad picture of what life would look like without your product and if they don't take action. For email 6, this will be the final email reminder, and this is where you include testimonials, frequent asked questions. Typically, it's a shorter email as it acts as a final reminder, so this would be called the last chance email for email number 6. I've grouped them all in here, but you would repeat the same process again. This email would emphasize testimonials, showing proof, and asking people what's holding them back from taking action and purchasing your product. And you will end email 5 and 6 with a call to action to buy your product. Then we'll click on done. Okay guys, I'm just going to reduce this and pull it down so that you can see. Now basically, this is a welcome email series sequence. And there's different types of email sequences for different types of goals. So for this one, we're trying to nurture a prospect and lead them to buy a product. And there are essentially 5 to 6 emails in this sequence. So for your welcome email sequence, I recommend anywhere from 5 to 6 emails. Now that you understand what to put in your emails, let's go through how to format your emails. So I'm going to go over here and hover over these 3 dots, which you can't really see. But once you hover over that, you can click on this pencil icon to edit that. So I'm going to scroll down to message, and in order to format your emails, the following toolbar is available. So this button is to bold your text, italicize it, underline it. This will place a cross in your text, so I'm going to untick this. This would be to hyperlink any specific text. You could change your text under normal to a heading, or just scroll down and keep it to normal as a body text. You could also number list your text by highlighting it and clicking this, or you can turn it into a bullet point by clicking here. That's pretty much it. You will click update. Now, once you've completed all your emails in the sequence, there are 2 options to trigger this email sequence. So option 1 is going back up top and clicking on add trigger. Over on the right hand side, you can trigger this email sequence based on tags. So early on in the first tutorial, I'll show you how to set up tags with categories of tags. So for this particular sequence, let's say that our tag is under the prospect category. In select tag, it will be free anabolic meal plan tag. So essentially, we can trigger this email sequence once a tag of free anabolic meal plan is applied to the contact. Now we can close out of this and say that let's trigger this email sequence if someone is added to the health website list, or we can close out of this and say that I only want this email sequence to trigger when someone opts into the free anabolic meal plan form, and then you can press done. That's how you can configure the starting rule to trigger all 6 emails in this particular sequence, right? So I'm going to close out of this. and just press save, you can see here that the free meal plan welcome series is now added as a sequence. Let's go through option two, which is creating an automation to trigger this email sequence. So we'll go over here and click on automations, then click automation. Now I've already created a test automation, but what we're going to do is we're going to delete that and create a new automation by clicking on new automation. Under automation name, we'll call that free meal plan welcome series. And this is how automations work. You can trigger an automation if something happens, then this other thing should happen. Under if, we can click on this drop down arrow and say that if a lead is assigned a tag and they are in the prospect category and the tag under select is free anabolic meal plan, I'll click on add. Then you'll click on this, subscribe them to sequence, click on this, the free meal plan welcome series sequence, and then click on add. So essentially this automation is saying if a contact is tagged with free anabolic meal plan, then subscribe them to the free meal plan welcome series and then press save. And the last thing to do is press the play button to activate and start this automation. And if you ever want to pause an automation, just click on this pause button here to stop the email sequence from starting. So guys, to recap, you can go to campaigns, sequence, go back to the sequence that you created, click on this drop-down arrow, click on edit, click update, and select the trigger over here in order for your email sequence to occur. So guys, even if you don't set up a trigger here, you can create an automation through if and then rules. So I'm going to close out of this and exit, go back to automations, click on automations, and instead of creating the trigger through the email sequence, you can trigger that sequence through an automation. So it's really good when you have a contact on your email list who has a specific tag applied to them, and the automation will take them through a different journey. Let's click on edit here. And using this existing automation, if you click under select, you can select any of these conditions to trigger an automation. Now, I'm going to cover all these automations in future videos. However, the automation that would be most beneficial for you, especially when you're selling products and services, is the purchase a product trigger. So we'll click on this and then go under here. Now, this is really cool because GrooveMail is connected to GrooveSell. So I can say that if a contact has purchased a product, under this drop-down arrow, I can select Amy Tests, which is the product funnel I've created. Under here, Amy Coaching Tests is my product name. And over here, the price point I would like to create an automation around is called Amy Coaching 30. And then I'll click Add. Under then, I'm just going to delete this. You can select add a tag, click on this, and the tag would be under buyers. Click on this and select purchase 30-minute coaching tag, and then click add. Once a contact is applied a tag, you can also subscribe them to another sequence by going to select, subscribe to sequence. Under this section, I'm going to click on test and then click add. Now, naturally, you would set up another email sequence for buyers as per this tutorial that I've just gone through and select that buyer's email sequence here. And then you can press save. So essentially, you can create another automation called buyer's email sequence. Under here, you can specify that if someone purchases a specific product, then tag them with purchase XYZ product and initiate a buyer email sequence and then press save. I'll close out of this because we don't want to change this particular email sequence, and then you would press play to initiate that automation. All right, guys, I hope this video helped you out. If it did, hit that like button for me. Leave me a comment if this worked for you. Help me get to 1,000 subscribers. Until next time, have an awesome week and see ya.